The following story has been brought to you by StoriesToInspire.org.
Rav Chaim Shmulevitz had a Talmud of the Me that lived in America and who had a very, very sick child. And this Talmud sent a message, a friend, someone who's learning in the yeshiva, please ask Rav Chaim Shmulevitz to daven for my child. His child was very, very sick. I need Rav Chaim to daven for my child. So Rav Chaim davened for the child with kavana. Unfortunately, the child took a turn for the worse, and the friend had to go back into Rav Chaim and tell him the sad news to stop davening because the child is no longer amongst the living. And Rav Chaim said to him, "Thank you very much for telling me. Please send a message over to my Talmud that I'm thinking about him and pass on that message." When the Talmud left the room, an amazing thing happened. Rav Chaim Shmulevitz burst into uncontrollable tears. He was crying with real tears. And they said, "Rabbi, I don't understand. A minute ago you were told the news. It took a few minutes to say over the message whatever you wanted to say over your Talmud. He left. Now you start crying. What's the pshat?" He said, "Very simple. Because I saw when he came in, he wanted to tell me the news, but he was so much betzar that if I would have started crying, it would have added to the tzar. He would have been in tzar more than he is now. I couldn't do that to him. So I controlled myself." Rabbi said, "You know what that is? To control yourself, lo'aleinu rachmana lishlam, you should never know such things. But to control your emotions, your midas, in a way that doesn't cause somebody else tzar, is such a tremendous midah, such a tremendous thing." Famous maaser. Couple came to Rabbi Shlomo Zalman asking for children, and the husband comes in and he cries and he says, "Rebbe, I've been to everyone, I've tried this one, I've tried that one." And Rabbi Shlomo Zalman says, "I'm sorry, I can't help you. I can't help you. So he turns away and he leaves, goes back home. 2 minutes after he arrives home, Shlomo Zalman's at the door, knocking at the door. Rabbi Shlomo Zalman Orbach is there. He says, "Rebbe, what are you doing here? I just came to you, how could you?" He says, "There's nothing I can do for you, but I want to cry with you. I want to show you that I care." That's what real chesed is to be careful of somebody else's feelings. We don't live in a bubble, you know. We don't live life on our own. Whether we are married, whether we're in a dormitory, whether we have chavrusas, whether we have employers, whatever it may be, wherever we are, wherever we're holding in the world, we don't live by ourselves. The reason that the Rabbeinu Shalom put us into the world according to Vilna Gaon is tikkun amidas. But it's also in a way that we live with other people so that we work on ourselves. Says the Vilna Gaon again, as we mentioned, the Ikke Chesed, the Ikke Gemilas Chasadim, is to be careful what someone else is going through. Is to live life thinking, how can I help somebody else? And even when I help him, I'm helping him in a way that he feels bekovedik. He doesn't feel that he's looking down upon. He doesn't feel someone that's being insulted. It's someone that's careful for somebody else's feelings.
Enjoyed this story? Come again. Bring a friend. StoriesToInspire.org.